guys. So these are my new protein drinks. I had one this morning. I had the caramel kind this morning. It was pretty good. I have not tried the chocolate yet, but I'm hoping that will be good too. Normally, I always get the chocolate drinks. But the best part about these drinks is look at the back, you guys. So the total fat is 3 grams. 160 calories for this drink. The sodium is 280. And the sugar is 1 gram and 3 grams of fiber. This is pretty good. This is like one of the best protein drinks with low carbs. So I'm in my macros. I'm not over anything. I'm not over my sodium. I'm not over my carbs. And I'm not over anything, basically. These are great.
I am in Salome's room. Not by choice. Because this little girl right here. Can I show you now? First of all, look at this shirt I have on. Ethan gave me this shirt. And gave her one. Because she wanted us to wear pink. Because she bought balloons. For Salome and some pretty flowers.
Pink.
Y'all, yeah, for her launch day, which is today.
Period. Make sure y'all go shop. If y'all don't shop, I'm not messing with y'all.
I'll put her link in the description. I don't know how I got. Let me show y'all Ethan. Mr. Ethan, who don't want to be on film, went and got a pink shirt for Lay. He went and got a pink shirt, y'all. I'm going to show y'all. He went and got a pink shirt. Look, he turned around. He don't want y'all to see. But he went and got a pink shirt and gave me and Lay one.
Y'all asked for one.
I did not ask you for no pink shirt. Alright, turn around.
No, I don't need to turn around.
That's Ethan.
You like our pink shirt? It's pretty.
I love
them. It's time to turn up.
It's time to turn up. Let's get the Bible. Oh, we got a pink Bible. Where's my Bible, y'all?
What they going to do?
Who?
The pink.
Turn up with a pink Bible. Hey.
Yeah.
We're going to turn up. And what we going to read? We're going to read Joshua. We're going to read Job. We're going to read Paul for pink.
Yeah. Okay. Lit. It's a party.
She always messed stuff up. She always got to mess it up. I don't know.
Does she know he's coming?
Who?
Does
Salome
and Warren
coming?
Oh,
Warren's coming. Yeah, they're together. Oh. We got one out pink.
Shirts.
Get me out of there. This whole pink, dirty room.
Don't talk about my sis while she's not here.
Oh, my goodness.
Where is this at?
Go ahead and ruin the surprise. Look at him under choking on the floor. What is wrong with you? And the beautiful people get to see it. Ethan choking, y'all.
What?
Shut up. Let my neighbors stomp if they want to stomp. That's how they walk. Fee, fa, fo, fum. What you gonna say? Congratulations. Say it, dude. You gonna say? Congratulations!
Y'all so crazy. Y'all so pink.
Hey, girl.
Everybody wearing pink. Yeah. Okay, I see it. Oh, y'all so sweet.
And what you got?
Something.
Okay.
We're gonna go get.
You know what?
Lit.
You know what? We got
flowers. Pink flowers.
Oh my gosh, Lit. Oh my. You is crazy.
The balloons. They're so cute.
I didn't even know they was that big. Like, I like them that big. They're cute.
What's up, my beautiful people? I hope y'all are doing awesome today. It is Saturday. Today is the 12th. It's kind of gloomy. Oh, Amber just messaged me from Jamaica. I miss her so much. Hold on, Amber. But I have a little bit of sunshine. Lay bought Salome these beautiful flowers. Can y'all see them? Hopefully the light won't mess them up. But they're so Man, they're so beautiful. I wish you could see how beautiful. Let me see this way. They're legit so gorgeous. And my daughter did not put them in water. And I have this picture on the table. So I just put them up there. And y'all, she also bought her a cake. Remember last night? Lay went and got her a cake. Ethan put the bag over it so it won't tempt me. Because you know how your girl is. But this is what my house is looking like. It needs to be clean. Trash. Me and Ethan about to go. So we about to take this trash out. I'm going to come back and hit those few dishes that are left. Oh, y'all probably like, why are you showing us that? Honestly, I don't know. But I just feel like it holds me accountable. I handle business when I show people what I need to do because I need to clean. But I'm about to go a couple of places. I don't know. I'm a little bit, y'all, I've been so moody since I've been eating, like, clean. Like, just like, oh, what's the word I'm looking for? Not sad. Maybe a little down. Last time I weighed, I was 201.0 today, so 201.0, I'm telling you, my body is trying to keep me in them twos. Like, I was just 201.4, so 201.0. So I've lost some ounces, and I'm hoping to be, I'm guessing I will hit the ones right before Thanksgiving. I want it to be like 190 something, like closer to the 180s by Thanksgiving, because I want it to like be able to like, you know, enjoy a little bit on Thanksgiving Day. But I put the macros for my Thanksgiving meal, and I'm over my fat. And the only thing I'm eating, y'all, the only thing I wrote down in there to eat was I was gonna have a smoothie and a protein drink, and I was gonna have small amount of mac and cheese, small amount of collards, not really a small amount of collards, but small amount of mac and cheese, small amount of stuffing, no fried chicken, no oxtails, just turkey, because I can't do ham anymore. So, and then I said I was gonna have one piece of sweet potato pie, not even a piece of cake and ice cream, and it took me over my macros, not over my calories, but over my macros. And it's just like, I think I'm at about 1500 calories, and my calories are 1650, but the fat went over, and that's probably because of the sweet potato pie. I didn't even add the dinner roll. This stuff has got me stressed, and I have all that water down there to drink. Y'all, this is really stressful. I don't remember me trying to get healthy and be fit in 2020 this stressful. Like, is it just me? Is it because I'm getting older? Like, I literally today, I was like really sad, because today I just wanted to just eat whatever I wanted. I didn't feel like putting in the macros. I don't feel like trying to fix. I mean, and I'm not saying that because I can't make it my lifestyle, because I don't mind the food. Like, I took a picture of my food after I already started eating it, showed my niece. This is what I had. It ain't nothing special. It don't even look pretty. But it was so good. Lunch is not really going to be that great because I kind of had my dinner for breakfast. But for lunch, I'm going to have some oatmeal. I can't stand oatmeal. I just got to find some better meals, because I know I eat the same thing a lot. So I was going to have an oatmeal, an apple. What else did I say? Oatmeal, apple, boiled egg, I think a smoothie or something. I don't know, but of course, I made my numbers today. I mean, let me tell you something. Eating clean will do it for you. It will have your skin glowing. It will have your waist snatch. My waist has gone down again. Praise God. My waist and my lower stomach has gone down. I'm so grateful to God for that. I'm going to go look at those numbers today. But I ain't going to tell y'all yet. But just know your girl waist is going down, and I'm very proud. And I stopped holding my stomach in, so that's another thing. I used to hold my stomach in. Now I just let that thing hang out, because what's the point of holding in when you do it? Because you're just really cheating yourself. Because when they say people that have 35-inch waist or higher are more prone to have diabetes, not all the time, because I know some people that waist is bigger than that, and they don't have diabetes. But I guess on average. So, you holding in your stomach, who you tricking? You're not tricking that body, because that fat's still in there. So, but anyways, I'm excited about the inches going down. But Let me go because I have to go somewhere. And I will probably talk to y'all when I get in the car. But I really need to edit this video because I feel like my video... Now I'm in like two video modes. Like, at first it was like one video. And it went like an hour long. So now I'm going to have to make two videos out of this because I've been showing a lot of my workouts. And stuff like that because... I don't know. Some people may want to see it. Practice being patient. Thank you. All right, guys. So, it is Sunday morning, and I just made myself some breakfast. And I'm about to eat my breakfast real quick and get ready for church. I've already taken my shower, did my hair, like, you know, brush your hair. You know what I'm saying? Let me show y'all my breakfast because I have not been showing y'all my... This is my breakfast. It is one egg with 6 tablespoons of egg whites. 1 piece of sourdough bread. If you want carbs, sourdough bread is like the best, and like a teaspoon of jelly. It might be a little bit more than a teaspoon, but I think it's like a teaspoon. And then here's my premier protein, all right? And it's caramel flavor. So this is my breakfast. All right, guys, so I'm dressed for church. I'm gonna show you what I have on now. Mind you, this outfit that I have on, I've had it for the past 2 years, and I wore it a little bit different last time. I wore it tucked in, but I'm like maybe like 10 pounds away. Not really 10, maybe like 7 pounds away difference in my body weight since I wore it. So it actually fits probably the same, but I'm just feeling a little, you know how we women get. So let me show y'all real quick. I know y'all seen this. This is on my, I've posted a picture in this outfit. I'm gonna show y'all right here. That's the outfit. I used to wear it like tucked in, but I don't know, not really feeling confident enough to wear it tucked in today because of that right there. So we just put it out today, but this, it looks better tucked in. But, and it has this little thing on it. I have my little favorite boots I've been wearing lately. And this is the fit. So this is what I'm wearing. I probably could have tucked it in. We're going to feel comfortable, okay? We're not going to feel like our stomach is in my hair. I have tried with this hair. It's so, like, this closure. All I need is a new closure because the hair is not the problem. It's just this part, so but it's okay. But I have to go to church. I love you guys. I'll talk about y'all later. All right, y'all got so hot, so I just put my hair in a little ponytail bun thing. I know it might look better the other way, but... It was just too hot for me. So just fixed my hair. Now I'm really about to go. So I'll talk to y'all later. What's up, y'all? So church was really, really good. He preached from Amos chapter 7. And I can honestly say I don't think I've ever read that. And I'm going to go reread it before I try to even tell y'all because I need to go read it over. But he was just preaching from a place where people act like church isn't supposed to be political when basically the whole life of Jesus, his birth, his lifestyle, his death was all surrounded in politics and government. And it was like, it was a really good word, and it was about just people standing up for people and saying you stand up for one cause and not all. It was just a good message. Good message. It was good. Good job, Pastor. But yeah, I'm about to go to the gym. So let me go home, get dressed, and I'll probably talk to you when I'm on my way to the gym. All right, y'all. So I literally just got out of church, and I am headed inside of the gym, honey. So I will talk to y'all in a little bit. What was that you said now?
Can I put my flowers back in my room?
Can you put them back in your room? They were never in your room. You left them on the table with no water.
I took a picture.
Yeah, you left them on the table with absolutely no water. Now that is not no little cheap picture. That picture cannot get broken.
I got my own, but it's just small. Can you move those candles over a little?
Can I move the candles? You wouldn't have these flowers had I let them do what you had. And where do you want me to put these candles?
Just give me a minute. Okay, you can place them back.
And you better watch them. Watch them with them candles.
I'm trying to steal my flowers.
I wasn't trying to steal your flowers. I was saving your flowers. They was all drooped down. You be thanking me for saving them.
Thanking me? Thank you.
Gary. Y'all, I am slim thick.
With your cute ass.
So, look at my table now. It's not as pretty as it was. That's annoying. Very, very annoying.
Mine.
Throw this cake away.
Where's my...
Ethan wants it, though. He been eating every bit of that cake.
Pink.
And my people saw who you been texting. All right, you guys, so it is Monday. I already went to the gym. I have to do like 14,000 steps today, y'all, because I am trying to earn my little star, and I normally earn it every time. It's like 5 a month, but I'm behind. So I'm in the process of washing dishes, and it's 2:26. I went to the gym. I had breakfast and lunch, and I would like to do my walk before I cook dinner, because the dinner that I'm cooking tonight, I'll be eating the leftover portion of my chicken. I only get one piece of chicken tonight, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all why. I only get one piece of chicken because I wanted a sandwich today with cheese, and I wanted some popcorn. It's like low sodium, but I wanted some popcorn so bad because I bought it yesterday and I couldn't have it yesterday. So I had it today. So tonight I literally only get one chicken wing, 2 cups of Brussels sprouts, and I think 1 cup of green beans and a smoothie. And that's my dinner. I tried to take the smoothie away and see if I could have the chicken, but it was too much fat for 2 pieces. So I literally just get one piece of chicken and a smoothie for the rest of the night. And a bunch of water. I probably drank about 25 ounces of water so far. There's my water sitting there waiting for me to drink some more. I hope y'all are doing okay. Today I've been like up and down with my mood. I don't know what's going on. Like normally I get like feeling this way when, you know, like most women do, but I cannot shake my little moods. I've been like having some little sad days, little sad episodes. I guess it's just life. People do this. This isn't anything new. You know, all of us experience times where we're just like sad about certain things, wanting things to be different. I'm steady trying to make changes, steady trust and believe in God, but things just, you know, life is just doing what life does, and you just gotta be patient and wait it out. I mean, the same thing I tell my people, I tell myself, so. We just gonna trust God, put in His hands. I put stuff in God's hands. I promise you I do. But waiting on God to move sometimes can be, you know, very stressful. And the reason why it's stressful, I do believe, is because there's nothing that we can do. I mean, you can do something, but when you waiting on God to move, like I wait on God to move, I, you know, ask God to like lead me into the right directions to do right, the things that He wants me to do while I wait for Him to move. You know, and it's just sometimes it can be very, you know, frustrating. Not that you're not trusting the Lord, just because He knows more than me. And I know He knows more than me. And I know He knows what's best for me. But still just waiting sometimes gets hard. I think y'all know what I'm saying. I hope I'm making sense. But that's it. But I'm about to finish like straightening up my house. Finish washing my dishes. Probably vacuum. And thaw out my chicken, so after I finish my walk, I can cook it. I'm probably going to start that walk about 3:30. Yeah. But, that is that, y'all. I believe in my heart that by Saturday, we're going to be in the 100s, honey. We're not going to go on no scale until Saturday morning. Should we do it Saturday morning? Yeah, Saturday morning. We're going to see 100s. 100s. The 100s. Who in the 100s? Who in the 200s? If you in the 200s, if you in the 200s, put a heart. If you in the 100, put a muscle, baby. And if you in the 300s, put a bikini because you can wear it.